Researchers have found a way to stop humans from aging. Lomonosov, Moscow State University, and Stockholm University have combined forces for this groundbreaking discovery. Together, they were able to complete a successful study which has found a way to delay the process of aging in humans. Obviously, so far the tests have only been performed on rodents, which is pretty standard. But it's expected this will lead to extremely positive benefits in human healthcare. Vladimir Skolichev is a renowned Russian biologist, and he led the study that experimented with genetically modified mice. In these specific mice, a single mutation was introduced into the genome. This mutation accelerated the mice's lives, and instead of living more than 2 years, these mutated mice lived for less than a year. Also, they developed many age-related diseases and defects. The group of researchers then treated the group of 100-day-old genetically modified mice with a synthetic compound called SKQ1, which was put into their water. SKQ1 is an artificial antioxidant which targets the mitochondria. The second test group of mice were given pure water. By the time the mice aged 200 to 250 days, the control group rapidly aged. They were developing alopecia, losing a lot of weight, moving a lot more slowly, and their body temperature had decreased. On the other hand, these were dramatically decelerated for the mice treated with SKQ1. Unfortunately, aging can't be stopped altogether, but it would be nice if in the future the process could be slowed down a bit. Welcome back everyone, I'm Court McGinley. I hope you're having a wonderful week so far. Before we get into today's stories, I want to remind you guys to please subscribe to this awesome channel if you haven't already. And also show us some love by giving this video a big thumbs up. Alright, as you guys know, we have a bunch of interesting news stories headed your way, so without further ado, let's get started. Next, yesterday a fire broke out on the roof of Trump Tower in New York. Firefighters were called to the Fifth Avenue skyscraper at 7:20 in the morning, and the smoke could be seen across the sky and carried for several blocks. Luckily, no injuries were reported. A lot of people were curious what caused the fire. The FDNY have revealed that it was caused by the building's heating and cooling system. President Trump was not in his apartment at the time of the fire, as he was in Washington. Luckily, firefighters were able to keep the blaze under control so it was unable to spread to other parts of the building. This could have been so much worse, so it was a good thing the firefighters got there as soon as they did. Next, a super rare blue blood moon eclipse is coming our way. This only shows up once every 150 years, so the fact that we get to experience this in our lifetime is pretty cool. NASA are advising people to head outside on January 31st so that we can see the super blood moon eclipse. This is a combination of the blood moon, super moon, and a total lunar eclipse. That's pretty cool. If you're one of the people looking up to the moon that night, you'll see a larger than average moon. It will be 30% brighter than usual, and since there will also be a lunar eclipse, the whole moon will appear to be turning a deep red shade. About this, the website Space says, "A blue moon is when two full moons happen in the same calendar month. Lunar eclipses occur when the moon passes into Earth's shadow, and the supermoons happen when the moon's perigee is closest approach to Earth in a single orbit, which also coincides with a full moon." Next, do you guys remember last week when I told you Cadbury came out with some white chocolate cream eggs and how some of them had cash prizes inside? Well, it turns out if you don't work at a supermarket, the odds of you winning aren't very high. And that's because all of the supermarket workers are unwrapping the eggs for themselves in search of the grand prize of £2,000. Yep, staffers are just unwrapping them before they are even put out onto the shelves. But if you're lucky enough to go and get your hands on a winning egg, then make sure you call the number printed on the voucher inside of the foil wrapping to claim your prize. Next, the world's richest country is expanding. Monaco may be the second smallest country in the world, but not for much longer. The $2.3 billion expansion project is expanding into the Mediterranean Sea by 15 acres. Currently, Monaco's 38,000 residents squeeze into less than 1 square mile of land. Basically, that's smaller than Central Park in New York. And when an additional 40,000 people come over from France and Italy every day to work, it's a bit of a problem. So this expansion is kind of necessary. The expansion is expected to fully be completed in 2025. And the new district, Portier Cove, will be able to house up to 1,000 residents in luxury apartments and villas that will sell for up to $4.1 billion. Monaco is one of the most sought out places to live in the world, and therefore it's the most expensive place to buy property. The government in Monaco will oversee the project, while private financiers will front the cost of construction, and in turn they will profit from the sales of real estate. Seems like a pretty smart business move. Next, whale saves snorkeler from shark. Yeah, this is a pretty incredible thing to see. The video was taken by Nan Hauser, and in it we see how this whale saves her from a shark. The male humpback attempted to push Nan through the water with his head before tucking her under his fin to hide her. At first, Nan was a little confused at what was going on. That was until she saw a 15-foot tiger shark that was lurking around them. Something like this has never been captured on film before, and Nam believes that this just proves that whales do in fact have a protective nature. Something else that was revealed that was out of shot. There was another whale that was slapping its tail to keep the shark at bay and away from Nam. Here's a clip. Next, it's recently been announced that Pink will have the honor of performing the national anthem at Super Bowl 52 on February 4th in Minneapolis. It's also been confirmed that this year's halftime performer will be Justin Timberlake. Now all we need to wait for is the news on what teams will be playing in the Super Bowl. Next, for all of you Game of Thrones fans out there, the 8th and final season has been confirmed for 2019. This season will consist of 6 episodes. The show has become insanely popular ever since it hit TV screens back in 2011. The show has won multiple awards and was nominated this year for the best television series of the year at the Golden Globes. This upcoming season is going to be the most secure yet. It's even said the actors are going to be given earpieces so that they can be fed their dialogue to deliver line by line. And there you have it, that's all the stories I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.